each evening from December to December. Before you drift to sleep upon your cot, think back on all the tales that you remember of Camelot. Ask every person if he's heard the story, and tell it strong and clear if he has not, that once there was a fleeting wisp of glory called Camelot.
Camelot, Camelot, my golden years a person was. But in Camelot, Camelot, those were the legal laws.
Where once it never rained till after sundown, by 8 a.m. the morning fog had flown. Don't let it be forgot that once there was a spot for one brief shining moment.
I shouldn't say these things.
That's why we're here, isn't it? Talk about what happened.
Is this a confession?
Oh, only if there's something you regret.
Everyone knows my story.
God isn't interested in stories. He's interested in the truth.
I came here looking for sympathy, Father.
Of course.
Father, are you listening?
I'm listening. Yes, I think so.
I think God is cruel.
Well, now you're getting into trouble. God is love. And God is everywhere.
Was he in the bullet that killed Jack?
Absolutely.
Is he inside me now?
Yes, of course, yes.
Well, that's a funny game he plays, hiding all the time.
The fact that we don't understand him isn't funny at all.
There's a heaven and there's your God with all his empty promises. What kind of God takes a father from his two little children?
Our Lord sacrificed his only son.
And my two babies. Arabella in the womb. Patrick, 39 hours on Earth, just long enough to fall in love with him. What did I do to deserve that?
No.
Jack and I hardly ever spent the night together. Not even that last night in Fort Worth.
Your husband loved you, Mrs. Kennedy, I'm sure of it.
I seem to remember there being more to our vows. Don't look at me like that. I was First Lady of the United States. Women have endured far worse for far less. There are two kinds of women. Those who want power in the world, those who want power in bed. Of course, now what am I left with? When men see me now, what do you think they feel?
Sadness. Compassion. Desire, maybe. You're still a young woman, Mrs. Kennedy.
I used to make them smile. No one understands the pain he was in and how loyal he was to some of his friends who were so crude. Jack wasn't, of course, but he could get caught up in it. Still, he was a great father. I picture him on that rocking chair in his office, Caroline and John at his feet. How could I hate him?
Take comfort in those memories.
I can't. They're mixed up with all the others. I lie awake at night, and all I can think is, I should have been a shop girl or a stenographer. Should have married an ordinary, lazy, ugly man.
Let me share with you a parable. Jesus once passed a blind beggar on a road, and his disciples asked, "Who sinned, this man or his parents, that he should be born blind?" And Jesus said, "Neither this man nor his parents sinned. He was made blind so that the works of God could be revealed in him." And with that, he placed mud on his eyes and told him to wash in the pool of Siloam. And the man did, and he came back seeing. Right now, you are blind, not because of your sin, but because you have been chosen, so that the works of God can be revealed in you. Why are you really here?
I needed to talk.
You say that you pray every night to die, that your children have no use for you. You wish only to be with your husband. And yet, I'm not burying you today. There comes a time in man's search for meaning when one realizes that there are no answers. And when you come to that horrible, unavoidable realization, you accept it or you kill yourself. Or you simply stop searching. I have lived a blessed life, and yet every night when I climb into bed, turn off the lights, and stare into the dark, I wonder, is this all there is?
You wonder?
Every soul on this planet does. But then when morning comes, we all wake up and make a cup of coffee.
Why do we bother?
Because we do. You did this morning. You will again tomorrow. But God, in his infinite wisdom, has made sure it is just enough for us.
Once more, Mrs. Kennedy has expressed her desire to reinter the bodies of the two children they lost to rest alongside their father. She got that part right. She wants them to always remember, for one brief shining moment, there was a, yeah, Camelot, yeah.
Don't let it be forgot that once there was a spot for one brief shining moment.